Alright, welcome back to Aaron's Hobbies Presents. Thanks for tuning in. Today's gonna be another behavior video, and as you see, third time in the video, I'm wearing the same clothes. I'm trying to get a bunch of these videos done. I've started teaching a tech class at night, and so I'm super, super busy, so I haven't had a whole lot of time to make any videos. Alright, so let's jump right into this. We're gonna go into another tip of love and logic, and this is about building a relationship. I tell people, if you don't have a relationship with kids, nothing else will work. I try to think about love and logic the same way I think about relationships. If you have a relationship at home with someone that you care about, you'll go above and beyond to help them out. If you have a very poor relationship with a friend or with a spouse, you're probably not very likely to go above and beyond to make them happy. So same thing with my kids. I want to have a great relationship with them so that they know I'll go above and beyond for them, and they'll also do the same for me. I start building relationships the morning they come in. At the door, I'm standing at that door every single morning. I'm doing some sort of physical interaction. It could be a high five, a pound, a butterfly, even a finger five, just something that the kids are comfortable with. You've got to have some choices because some kids are not huggers or don't like to shake hands. So they have control and they get to make the choice of that makes them comfortable. So I meet my kids at the door, some sort of physical touch. Eye contact is very, very important. I get down their level. I'm so glad you're here. Welcome to Mr. Rogers' class. So glad you're here. You know, whatever it is, I'm making eye contact so they know that I really care about them. So the next thing, when I'm walking around my room, I'm constantly making a physical connection with my kids. Whether it's just a little simple poke and a little wink, or ruffling their hair, or giving them a little eye, you know, the little elbow, or, you know, just shaking on their chair, just playing with them, just ever slightly, so that when I'm walking around, they know I'm constantly building that relationship with them. I also do a lot of I notice. Okay, so when you say I notice, it keeps the power in the children's hands, and it lets them know I pay attention. If I say I like, then I'm making that control about me, and they might not like what they're working on. If I say, hey, I noticed that you used a lot of colors in your drawing, way to go. Or, hey, I noticed that you've got Ninja Turtles on your shirt, awesome. Or, hey, I noticed you've got some silly socks on today, those are so cool. So when I'm noticing things, I'm just letting them know that I care about them, that they're important enough for me to notice just little small things. And you'd be surprised that when you notice things about your kids, their light in their face just really beams. The next thing. I don't ask things of my kids that I don't ask of myself, okay? To build that relationship takes trust. And so I don't ask things of my kids that I wouldn't expect them to ask of me, okay? I don't tell them they have to do it right this very second, okay? Give them some options, give them some control in that situation. That relationship goes both ways. And then my last way that I build relationships with my kids is I apologize and I let them know when I make mistakes. They need to know that I'm fallible. They need to see what it looks like when I make mistakes and how I handle it. And they need to know that I'm truthful. If I make a mistake, I don't try to play it off like I meant to. I let them know, you know, Mr. Rogers did this because that was such a bummer choice. I'm not going to be doing that anymore because X, Y, and Z. So I start building that relationship with physical touch, eye contact, and then that trust between relationships with my kids. All right, well, I hope that was super helpful in using love and logic in your classroom. Thanks for tuning in, and I'll see you next time.